75 days ago, I collected some river sand, algae, and water from the edge of a waterfall and placed them in a jar, sealed it, and took it home. A few weeks later, the jar transformed into an ecosystem. I want to introduce you to the tiny creatures inside the jar, one by one. If you're ready, let's go to the waterfall first. There are many small organisms, both visible and invisible to the eye, that make up freshwater and saltwater ecosystems. Some of them can be harmful to human health, while others may carry diseases. I'm sure many of you have swum in these waters and even drank from them. Don't worry, most of these organisms are harmless to human health, and they play a significant role in the ecosystem. However, avoid drinking water from unknown sources. Still waters, in particular, can easily make people sick. I went to the nearest water source with my jar to identify these organisms under a microscope and closely monitor their development to share with you. I scooped up a few fish netfuls of substrate from the bottom of the water source and put them into the jar. There are many beneficial bacteria in this substrate that will help keep the water in the jar clean. I simulate this substrate when setting up the aquariums at home. I take water from a random spot and fill the jar with it. There is a lot of life in the substrate I collected from the bottom and in this water. Plants are one of the most important components for ecosystem health. Algae are a type of plant as well. These algae will provide oxygen for the organisms inside the jar and help maintain healthy water quality. Additionally, algae serve as both a food source and a habitat for many organisms. I placed a few stones covered with algae into the jar. This way, organisms that need hiding will be able to find shelter under the stones and feel secure. Everything is ready now. I'll close the jar's lid and take it home. The water looks very cloudy, but it will be crystal clear in a few days. A few weeks later, the water has cleared up, and I can see some of the organisms with the naked eye. Some are only barely visible through a magnifying glass. Additionally, very tiny creatures are moving among the sand. I'm eager to show you the organisms I've identified. I want to start with a type of worm first. Detritus worms are small, often aquatic worms that play a crucial role in ecosystems by feeding on detritus decomposing organic matter, such as dead plants and animals. Common detritus worms include tubifex worms, which are found in freshwater environments, and other similar species in both freshwater and marine settings. They are typically found in sediments at the bottom of water bodies, such as lakes, rivers, and ponds, as well as in soil and compost. Detritus worms vary in size and shape. They are generally slender, elongated, and can be white, pink, or reddish in color. These worms consume organic debris and microorganisms present in the detritus, breaking it down into smaller particles. This process helps recycle nutrients back into the ecosystem. By feeding on decomposing material, detritus worms contribute to nutrient cycling and soil health, improve soil aeration, and enhance water quality in aquatic systems. Many detritus worms reproduce quickly, which allows them to play a significant role in their environments. Detritus worms are important for maintaining the balance and health of their ecosystems by promoting the breakdown of organic matter and supporting other organisms in the food web. Our next creature is easily visible to the naked eye and is one of the largest. Daphnia are fascinating creatures for a variety of reasons beyond their role in aquatic ecosystems and their use as aquarium food. They have a distinct curved body encased in a transparent shell called carapace. They have large compound eyes, a pair of antennae that they use for locomotion, and small appendages for feeding. Their jerky swimming pattern resembles that of a flea, which is why they're commonly called water fleas. This movement is driven by rhythmic beats of their second pair of antennae. Under favorable conditions, Daphnia reproduce asexually. Females produce eggs that develop into genetically identical offspring without the need for fertilization. This rapid reproductive ability allows populations to grow quickly. In response to environmental stress, Daphnia will switch to sexual reproduction. Males are produced and fertilized eggs are encased in a tough, protective shell called an ophidium, which allows them to survive harsh conditions until the environment becomes favorable again. Daphnia aren't only ecologically significant as a keystone species in freshwater ecosystems, but also highly valuable in research, aquaculture, and aquarium keeping due to their adaptability, rapid reproduction, and ecological roles. Let's look other one. Cyclops have an elongated, cylindrical body with a single large eye near the front of their head, which gives them their name. They have two long antennae that help with movement. Most cyclops are transparent or lightly colored, though some species may appear slightly orange or greenish depending on their diet and habitat. Cyclops are omnivorous. They feed on microscopic algae, bacteria, and detritus, but they are also predators of smaller zooplankton, including Daphnia and small aquatic larvae. In this way, they help maintain the balance in planktonic populations. They are strong swimmers, moving in short, jerky motions using their antennae. This characteristic hopping or darting motion is a distinctive feature of copepods like cyclops. Cyclops reproduce sexually. The female carries eggs in two distinctive egg sacs attached to her body, making her easy to identify. After the eggs hatch, the young go through several stages of development before reaching adulthood. Next creature, Chidorus, is a genus of small freshwater cladocerans, a group of microscopic crustaceans commonly referred to as water fleas, like their relatives Daphnia. Chidorus species are important components of freshwater ecosystems, where they contribute to the plankton community and play a key role in the food web. They have a distinctive, rounded, and slightly flattened body, which gives them a more spherical appearance compared to other cladocerans. Their body is enclosed in a transparent, chitinous shell. Like most cladocerans, Chidorus possess a single compound eye located centrally on their head. In summary, Chidorus are small, adaptable freshwater crustaceans that contribute to the balance of plankton populations in aquatic ecosystems. They play an important role in nutrient cycling and serve as a key food source for many fish and other aquatic organisms. We've come to the end of this episode. If you'd like to see more creatures, please let me know in the comments and I'll make a second episode accordingly. Also, I'd be really happy if you subscribe to my channel. I post regularly on Instagram as well. You can find the link in the description. As always, thank you so much for watching this video. Peace and love.